So I spent a lot of time on this channel showing you great performing campaigns and how to do them so you can promote your own music. But it's been a while since I've showed you what happens when things flop and all the things that can go wrong in a campaign. So in this video, I'm going to share five things that you should not do in your music Facebook ad campaigns. And number one is going to be not using a pixel or not properly setting up your events. And what this involves is, like, if you're doing a link click campaign, you're not properly tracking all the people that clicked. So you can't retarget people that clicked to check out your song on Spotify or whatever later because you're not pixeling them. And setting up a pixel is entirely free. So if I switch to my screen here, this is Facebook ads, and you go to business tools up here and then go to events manager. And if you don't have a pixel, it's gonna guide you through some steps for how you can set it up. There'll be like a very obvious pop-up here that says like add data source or whatever, and then you just add a pixel. Now, you wanna make sure you do this, and you wanna make sure to track every single like website involved event, like sending people to Spotify using like a landing page or a deep linking service or whatever. Check out my other videos for the tutorials on that stuff. But the next thing that's part of the same problem is not properly setting up your events. Now, if you're using something like ToneDen, it's pretty simple because with ToneDen, if you're using their landing page service, you can just use the view content conversion. But a lot of people will just assume that it works and they don't check it. And so whatever service you use, you always want to check that it works. And the way that you do that is you get whatever link that you set up, you know, you put your pixel code on the website and then you get your landing page already. You can go to this test events page. And what you do is you just drop your link inside of this test events and then go on the landing page and fire off the event. And there'll be a thing here that shows you all the events that fire off. And if you see that, you know that it's working. Now make sure you're using Google Chrome for this. A lot of people are like, hey, I can't do that. It only works on Google Chrome. I know it doesn't work correctly in Safari, at least as of right now. Now the other thing you could do is there's this really cool plugin called the Facebook Pixel Helper, and you can actually go on any website and see what pixels are on there. And this is a really great way to see what pixels are on the page and if events are firing correctly. And again, this is a Chrome extension, so just go to your Google Chrome extension store thing and you'll find the Facebook Pixel Helper in there. So number two is getting comfortable and not properly tracking your data. And this goes for tracking data on the Facebook side and tracking data on the Spotify side. For a while, I was getting very comfortable with my campaigns. I was getting win after win after win, so I would just launch campaigns the same way and just kind of see the results come in and assume everything was hunky-dory. But the problem was, everything was not hunky-dory. And the best example I can give of this recently is that audience network is very hit or miss. If you remember from my most recent Facebook ad tutorial video, I show that recently I started using automatic placements instead of custom placements. And the reason for this is because it was performing great. It was like cutting my ad cost in half and it was all resulting in streams. But I did that so many times in a row that I just assumed it was always going to work great. What started happening is that every so often a campaign would end up with all the results going to audience network. And for some reason, those results weren't converting into streams, listeners, saves, all of that. And I still don't know why yet, but my rule of thumb right now is don't use audience network. All you do is you go to custom placements and just uncheck audience network and leave the rest on. And that's what I'm doing right now. And you know, that's something that would have been fixed if I had just gone into Facebook ads. And my hair keeps flopping in my face. And I'll show you how to do it. You just click on one of your campaigns, and now we're in the ad sets. Now I can go to breakdowns by delivery and then placement. And this campaign, it wasn't a problem, but what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to look in the results. If you start seeing like audience network consuming all of your results and on Spotify, you're not getting the streams that you should be seeing, that's the problem. Now, in some cases, audience network will get a lot of the results, but you can see in this, it's not getting the majority, right? It's getting 10% or something of the results. In the campaigns that flop, I've noticed audience network will consume like 90% of all of the results, and then there'll be like no streams on Spotify. And I've, you know, again, this is, I didn't purposefully mislead you in that video. It was working for me and it still sometimes works. It's just the nature of marketing, right? Like things are constantly in flux and you gotta be on your toes. You can't ever get too comfortable and assume that things are still working. And so just make sure you're always tracking, digging through the data, and confirming it on Spotify. And when things aren't going right, do your research and figure out what's wrong. So number three is always using one ad. If you're just using one ad, you're missing out on a lot of opportunities. The creative, the video, the image is actually very important to how much your campaign ends up costing. And the reason for this is, let's say you're using a video. A lot of people will assume that the chorus is going to be the part that hooks someone into the song. But I've shown this in previous videos, but I'll remind you, if I go back to the same campaign for my song Chains, and I go to this pop music ad set, I'll turn off breakdown so it's a little easier to see. If we go to the cost per result, verse 2 was way cheaper than verse 1 or drop 2. And the actual visual is the same here. It's just the part of the song that I'm using. And this is a perfect example of how if you're just using one ad in your campaign inside of your ad sets, you're kind of missing out on a lot of potential optimization, you know, because you can't really premeditate what a random audience is going to like. This won't necessarily be the same ad that performs best inside of every ad set. So it's good to just get three or so different ads with different parts of the song, potentially different visuals too, and have them all in all your ad sets. So that way Facebook can just go and find the cheapest options for every single audience. Number 4 is a big one, and I see a lot of people doing it, and it really does make a difference. And that is not launching your campaign on the same day that your song actually comes out. What I do is when I have a song coming out, I'll get ready up to the midnight of launch, and I'll have all my ads ready. I'll have all my targeting in mind, and I'll be ready so that when the song drops on Spotify, I can grab the link, go to my landing page service, get all the other different services like Apple Music that I'm going to link there as well, make the ads, and by like 12:30, 1 in the morning, everything is published and it's in the review process. And you know, go to bed, wake up in the morning, your campaigns are live and they've already gotten data. And that means by the end of the day, you've already pretty much gone through the learning phase of your ads if your budget is big enough, and you're going to get a lot of results in opening weekend and the first week. What a lot of people do is they're like, oh, my song's out, I'm going to share it on social media. And then like Saturday comes and like, okay, cool, maybe I'll launch my ad campaign. And they launch it and then it's not ready till Saturday night. And then they've wasted the first few days, and the first few days are critically important to the duration for the performance duration of the song. I worded that really weird, but the first few days are very important for how the song is going to do over its lifetime. So make sure as early as you possibly can, at least the morning of the song release, preferably the night it comes out, go on Facebook ads, get everything ready, and drop it. If you really, really are concerned or you're crunched for time, you could get everything published and ready on Facebook ads ahead of time. And then on release day, just correct the link in the landing page service you're using and toned in or hyped it, and then just publish everything. And that way you don't have to spend like an hour messing around with Facebook ads in the middle of the night. So number 5 is actually a huge problem for me, and that is running multiple types of promotion at the same time. And I have this happen all the time where I'm talking to a student or I'm doing a consultation with someone and their save rate is really weird. It's like super low, but it looks like all the data is fine on Facebook ads. And then we look at the results and they have all their streams coming from other listeners' playlists. And so I'm like, oh, did you do like a playlist promo with this too? And they're like, oh, yeah. I'm like, oh, man. Now we have no way of knowing if all the results are coming from Facebook okay, or if it's just the playlist promo kind of like dive bombing the save rate. You have no way of knowing if you're doing all these different things at the same time. So you can't correct your Facebook campaign if it's not working. One of the other promo methods might be giving you good results, and maybe one of the other ones is doing bad. You'll have no way of knowing if that one's bad or if this one's bad. You're kind of completely blindsided by it. So what I recommend is if you have the budget to spread yourself across different promotional methods, you know, if you only have $100 or $300, just stick with one thing for this song. You can always mix it up in the next song. If you have a big enough budget to spread yourself across two different promotional methods, what I would do is for week one, just do Facebook ads. And then once it gets to the end of the first week, maybe start doing some SubmitHub playlist promotion, you know, drop $50 or something on playlist promo. So that way the impact of the playlist, it's still going to help you, but it's not going to make it so that you can't interpret your results. I'm just using the playlist one as an example. You know, that analogy goes towards using YouTube ads as well. Launch the YouTube ads later so that you can correctly discern how the Facebook ads are going. And then once you know how that's performing and you put the YouTube ads on top of it, you can see the difference between how your campaign's doing from when you started the YouTube one. So you can track the Facebook, track the YouTube, and measure your results across both of them. And that's very, very important when you're trying to figure out what's going wrong. And especially when you're learning, you really have no idea what's going on. So all of the examples I just brought up either happened to me personally or they were brought up in a consultation call with a student. And if you need help with your campaigns, you can actually book me with the link in the description so I can help you walk through these problems. Now, what you can also do is you can check out these videos in this playlist right here to learn more about how to use Facebook ads to promote your music. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.